children to our English language session. Children, we have been doing with the chapter on sentence. So children, I hope you have understood what a sentence is and you must have done all the exercises. Now, we'll continue with the chapter. Look at the pictures and match the columns. Now look carefully what everybody is doing. Komal is dancing. Anjali and Tom, the dog, are playing. Manish is riding a scooter. Ashish is playing a football and Maria is skating. Now here we have two columns and you will have to match them. So how will you do it? Komal, what is Komal doing? Komal dances gracefully. Anjali and Tom the dog, what do? They love each other. What is Manish doing? Manish rides a scooter. What is Ashish doing? Ashish loves to play football. And Maria skates very well. So this was fun, isn't it? Okay, now let's see what else is there to learn about sentence. Read these sentences. I go to school every day. These children play football. Now, can you identify the verbs in these sentences? So children, you must be knowing what a verb is. It is the action word. It tells what the noun or the pronoun is doing. So who is the noun or pronoun here? It is I. And what is I doing? He is going. So go is the verb in this sentence. These children play football. So who is the noun or pronoun? These children. And what are they doing? They are playing football. So play is the verb here. So I hope you have identified the verbs. Let's see what we have to do next. It is interesting to know that a sentence has two parts. Now in the previous sentences, you have known that there is a noun or a pronoun and there is a verb along with it. So a sentence has two parts. That is the noun part and the verb part. So what does the noun part say in a sentence? The noun or pronoun is what is being talked about. And what does the verb part indicate? It indicates that all that is said about the noun part. Now whatever is said about the noun or the pronoun is the verb part. Now let's see more about it. For example, The children are in the garden. So we have divided the sentence into two parts. The noun or pronoun part, that is the children, and the verb part, are in the garden. So the children is the noun part and are in the garden is the verb part. Let's see what it has to say more. The noun part is the subject of a sentence. So what is the noun part? The noun part is the subject of a sentence. It is the person or thing being talked about. So whatever is talked about, that person is the subject or the noun part. And whatever is being said is the verb part, and who is being talked about is the noun part. Now let's see, the verb part is the predicate. Now what is the verb part? The verb part is the predicate of a sentence. Now what does it tell? It tells us what is being done or said about the subject. So what does the predicate say? It tells what is being done or said about the subject. So the verb, which is called the heart of a sentence, is always a part of the predicate. Now let's do some exercises. Look at the pictures and write suitable subjects or predicates. So here is a picture given and you have to see it and then do it. So let's start doing it. Rashi dash. So this child is Rashi. What did she do? She threw a ball towards the wall. So she threw a ball towards the wall. So this is to be filled in the first sentence. So you have to write it down. The dog, what did the dog do? The dog ran with Rashi. So write it down over here. Dash bounced towards the boundary wall. So what will bounce? The ball. The ball will bounce towards the boundary wall. So write it down here. So this is number 2 and this is number 3. And lastly, it is the dog ran to fetch the ball. So write it over here. So children, I have marked all the answers. And now it is your work to write it down with your neat handwriting. So I did the first one for you and the second one will be done by you. So this will be your work to be done by yourself. Now let's see. Add suitable subjects and predicates to make sentences. Now I'll do only one sentence and the rest will be done by you. So this is a creative work that you need to do. The first sentence says the rabbit. So rabbit is the noun part of the sentence. So what does the rabbit do? The rabbit hops around the garden. So you can complete the sentence by saying the verb part, that is the rabbit hops around the garden. So children, I have done the first one for you and the rest you will try by yourself. Now, the question F. Complete the passages with suitable subjects and predicates. So children, I hope till now you have understood what a subject and predicate is. The boy who lived next door, dash picked all the grapes from the vine and ate them up. The boy who lived next door is naughty. Dash picked all the grapes from the vine. So, the boy picked all the grapes from the vine and ate them up. The farmer was angry. But the boy ran away. The angry farmer ran after the boy. So children, I hope you have understood what you have to do. Okay, now the second one will be done by you. So today we will do only this much and we'll continue with the rest of the work in our next class. So till then, have a nice day and have a better learning.